What if I told you a black waiter was forced to listen to people call him the N-word or just say the N-word loosely? Couldn't do anything about it. Let me first do this. I want to take you to the video. We'll get into the background of the story. Here it is.
Story time. A party full of people wearing Confederate flag gear just tried to come eat in our restaurant. Now, when I say a family decked out in Confederate flag gear, they literally had what could have been a two-year-old baby in a Confederate flag hoodie or whatever. And then under that, he has a Confederate flag onesie on. Like, it is never that deep, ever. And then other people that have hoodies, hats, all this. And they're sitting in the middle of the restaurant, too, which is just a terrible coincidence. And to top it off, one of our black servers had to take them because their section buddy was a white girl, but she took the last party and got stiffed. I guess it wasn't good. So I guess he had to take it, had whatever. So the whole time he's there, he said they're not talking to him. They're not really looking at him. They're N-word this, N-word that. While he's there at the table, y'all. While he's there at the table. Like, they're not even trying to be quiet. They're not even trying to stop. And this server is a server that's always happy, loud, outgoing, making sure everybody's good. He'll be like, you need help? You need help? Like, he'll literally go out of his way to help. And when he got quiet, like, we knew something was, like, wrong. So we're like, where's he at? Where's he at? And all this. And this man, he ended up going outside crying. And this is a grown-ass man. Like, he ended up going outside crying. And he still served them. He didn't throw a fit. He didn't do nothing and all that, which props to him. Because I would have been at that table. I would have heard the N-word, and I would have... Truly props to him. Because your girl, it would have been over.
Put up the picture. A viral TikTok video posted on Saturday describes how author Mandy, a black employee at the Westchester, Texas Roadhouse in Ohio, was forced to serve a table full of neo-Confederates. He says, and I quote, "They completely dehumanized me." The incident got so bad that management eventually had to tell all the black employees to stay away from the entire dining area until they left. Keep his picture up. Dear brother, you're a good man. You're a nice man, decent, happy. The company that decided to tell you and all black employees to stay away from the white racist patrons, that company does not respect you. I encourage you to seek employment elsewhere. Mandy, Mr. Mandy, 41 years of age, said he expected the party to be his last table for the night. A reservation was set for 11 people. But initially, only a small group showed up, including a baby wrapped in a Confederate coat. But Mandy said he didn't really notice customers' attire until more people joined the group. The rest of the parties walk in. The managers come and pull me aside and say, hey, if you have any issues with this table, let us know, Mandy said. Mandy told the Daily Beast that he properly focused in on the group when an older male customer sat down with them. I'm going to spill things that we offer, things that we have, what he may like. And he says, well, I'll tell you what, boy. Just give me a water with lemon. Mandy said that he grabbed the guest water, but the man kept rushing to finish his drink to order another, as if he was challenging the waiter, consistently calling him boy and never making eye contact. He said the rest of the party joined in on the older man's tactics, laughing and snickering throughout. Mandy said he spent 20 minutes just getting drinks. Mandy, Mr. Mandy, is a father of four, said his heart was broken when a five-year-old child with the group was directed to not speak to him while he served the table. You know why the child wanted to speak to him? Because the child doesn't understand racism yet. Child doesn't understand bigotry and hatred yet. That won't be the case for long. There's more. Then his mom chastises him in front of me. And she's like, you don't need to talk. He has a job to do. He needs to concentrate. The party allegedly ordered more than $400 worth of food. But Mr. Mandy said they complained so much that they had their bill knocked down to a fraction of that, which was probably the plan before they got there, dear brother. They also continued to distract other customers in the restaurant during a busy night, loudly using the N-word and creating a scene. Mandy said it got to be so much that he had to walk outside and cry. You know, I get really upset when people try to take dignity away from you. They was trying to take your dignity, brother. And your company, your managers, they allowed it. Now I know they're not going to like what I'm saying about them. Fine. It's true. Because if your management was appropriate, they would have went to those racists and said, get the hell up out of here. Don't you ever come back. I'll trespass your ass to jail. Real simple. You can enforce those rules. It's called private property rights. Let's put it up. Here's the restaurant. Mandy refused to go back to the party, which upset them. They're mad. Why? Because they think he's their slave. After receiving their food, they allegedly told managers that Mr. Mandy messed up their orders, demanding they would not leave until he made another visit to their table. When they eventually did leave, they waited outside in the parking lot as if for Mandy, only leaving once a manager threatened to call the police. Threatened to call the police? Threatened to call the police. You see? Now, if you don't think this is systemic, this is cultural, that this is bias inside of our psychology, think about this. Do you believe if, let's say, Black nationalists went to a white restaurant, okay, and they started to engage in conversations that were adversarial to the wait staff or that were critical or even downright rude to those around them, do you think the management would have said, hey, all white people, listen, just be okay with it. Just stay away from the table for a little while. All right, it'll be okay. No, they would have called the police. Okay? Now, keep in mind, because I don't want anyone to get it twisted, Black nationalists are not racist. But even in that context, they would have never been able to stay inside of that restaurant. Why do we play games with racist, violent people as if somehow it's something to play with? These individuals could have severely harmed Mr. Mann, and I'm sure given the opportunity that possibly could have happened. All right, Sharon, I was so upset when I saw this story. What are your thoughts here?
My focus, Dr. Richey, is on just the management and not the filth, because I think they are what they are. The management is my focus because there are too many people like this, white people who seamlessly blend in with society and allow this kind of indignant behavior. Yeah. They're the reason Emmett Till was hunted and Ahmaud Arbery was hunted. Yeah. They're the reason.
That's right. And the psychology is the reason why you don't get prosecutions until something happens, like a video turns up and all of a sudden you get an indictment, right? All right, we're going to follow this story. I do hope there's more to come with this. Young man, I really encourage you to seek every option you have available to you, because you have some, okay?